this one's. Look here. Hi, hi. So, you're quick. Hear myself. Maybe. Hello, everyone. Hello, Gloria, Pam, Belinda, Linda, Anne, Karen, Femke. Debbie, Hans, so many. So many. Nice. Yes, English this time, Jona. I wait a minute because I was very early. So people can come in. For the people that are there, please like and comment for to make a chance on the gift card. Katie, Ohio, hi. Oh, my comment was in Dutch. I newbie here in the UK. How are you doing, Martha? Happy for you doing. I'm doing fine, Belinda. I'm a little bit busy. Every year, December is a busy month. I always clean my agenda, but every time it's full every day. That is every December. The same story, but it works. Now I'm gonna start. As you see, I will make 2 planner pages today. I'm making a week planner for myself, only I'm a little bit behind. I'm at week 20 and I started last week, not the week before. So I must do a lot, but now I start going to with week 20. I shovel all the small stuff before me, so I can take the pages out as I planned them. Last week was the week for from Max Verstappen, week 49. And this was the back, so I go further with the back of this one, and I chose the big ones and the small, yeah, how do you say that, card elements. Only I wanted on the right side a pocket, and I die-cutted the pocket from this die, and I place it on the right side with tape. I tried to read the comments, but they are going so fast. Because there are some holes here, I don't do the tape to the end. Only here a little bit. I prepared a lot before. No worries, be happy you watch it, we no need to try. Okay. Now it's not possible to see all the comments and make something. First make these two loose, and then I do this ones a little bit, because I want to have it straight on the other page. So, and it's a little bit dark here, because otherwise the light is not good for you. So, so now I take this one and this one, and then I have a pocket. See? And in that pocket I wanted this. I have sample, yeah. You can do it both ways. You can die cut this and stamp this on it, or you can die cut a black one and on another piece of paper you stamp and you cut it, and when you cut it you get a small piece of the black round here. I have a sample made today. Let me look. This is for the live for tomorrow, so I know I have a sample made where I stamped it up right on the paper. You see, this one is stamped on the how do you say that, pocket tag, and this one I go cut out and then place it on the pocket. Lay it back before I mess up all. No, but I'm alone this Christmas. You are alone, Chris, this Christmas, Femke. That's not a very nice thing, I think. Alone at Christmas. But I think your parents are moved to another country. Is that right? I think I have read that somewhere. I leave a small 1 millimeter over. And then I take my little Tim Holtz scissor, because this is not a straight line. And on this piece I will write something about that day, that week. You see, and now I have small black. Can you see it? I look a little bit. Yes, yes. I glue it. Then you can see it better. Oh, the papers from the book you are. Yes, else from the Reminiscence book 3. I use it. I love all the Reminiscence books. So. Hello, Yvonne. Yes, this is a small piece of black paper around, but it looks nice, I think. This one I put in the pocket. Then I have a picture. And I have a new cutter. And this is the Tim Holtz Dekker. I use it for the first time. I don't know if that was by you, but... older pictures, older photos had this little jagged edge. Older pictures, and now the Tim Holtz Dekker give that jagged edge. And I had cut my photo, so I couldn't make this edge on the photos, but I thought I take a black piece of paper and that piece I give that edge. So I put a photo on the paper. I spoiled myself last week with that Tim Holtz Dekker cutter and some stamps and another stuff, and that's on this picture. So you can use all kind of pictures, and special in December, I have the week planner and I have the December day by day, so I need a lot of pictures, so I make from everything a picture. Dekker edge, yeah. So I place this here, I think, but I have some stuff laying here around me. I don't know if you had seen my video where I made this retro stamp, retro cards with this is with a marble stamp, and this is with texture stamp, and I don't know which one I use, the black one or the red one. The red ones are stamped with Distress H Mahogany. So I go look now, and I had the stamp December Stories, and I go tear the paper from this. I had done one side already, but I think maybe I should show it how I do it. I always tear the pieces to me, because then you get the nicest edged. This one was also meant on this paper, so and then I have also some stamped images, and I have some cards from Tim Holtz. This was a card from Tim Holtz, but I want all the black ones. This one is not a good one, I must. Black is also. I want to use some of these. Maybe smaller piece. Thank you, Debbie. And then one on this side. Yes. Yes, yes, yes. That is what I'm doing first. Take it, glue it almost to the half, and place it anywhere I like. So. Then I can use this one at the top. Black ones of paper is too white, the red ones are better. Yes, that's correct. I like the red ones better also. And I like it when the colors are almost the same. So it's matching better for me. I hope you all understand my Dutch English. So, then I add the whole paper with distress ink before I go further. And this is a vintage photo. And are you all ready for Christmas? Thank you, Sue. The Dutch English is perfect, Barbara, don't worry. Thank you. So, no. This one at the bottom, so. You do understand Dutch English. Yes, but Dutch is a difficult language to learn. English is a better language to learn. Only I speak it not a lot because I don't go on holidays the last few years, and on holidays I speak a lot of English. All the time, but now only when I do the live for a little bit Crow Design, I speak English. So then I had this card. This card is also from Tim Holtz. I have a whole, how do you say that? Container with all of Tim Holtz goodies. So I have two already. Tim Holtz and Elizabeth Craft Designs go so good together. Yes. My God, you made 124, so all Christmas cards. That's a lot. December stories makeup here. Maybe, but that is still. I must look at what I have on the other side. Yes, this one is, this round thing is coming out of the Irish shutter. It says stitch edged, and the stamp is from the new collection. I don't know if I have them here. Yes, it's CS 256 Cozy Days. But yeah, and I was looking for all the stuff I will use. I had an idea, but then you must make a picture, but I forgot it how I wanted it. But I think it's going to be good also. So, yes, this is the right page. Now we are going to the left page. Oh, I'm going fast. And because I wanted to, on the left page, the same paper as on the right page, I have made a border. Also, so it matches together. Even kijken, zo heb ik wat verplot. Oké. Now, as the Christmas cards I did for many years, I made 2 a month. I was in a group where we made 2 Christmas cards every month. So you have had at the end of the year, not to rush. But that group is not anymore, and my Christmas cards are always at the end, almost at the end. So, little dot. But I have had enough Christmas card this year, but most of the time I had left over, but that is not anymore since I'm not in that group anymore. So this border is from the same set. I go take the set and kijken. This boat, the pocket, and this border is from the 1652 Planner Essentials 8 set. Now I have 2 pictures. I'm really spoiled. Last week I got a big red box. And in that box, there were all yummy things. I cut the edges also with a deckled edge trimmer from Tim Holtz. Love stories envelopes. I can't wait. Is the paper not everywhere yet, Els? I thought it was Everywhere, yes. She calls my husband back to them in lockdown. Okay. You're also in lockdown, Sue? Oh, sorry to read that, Marianne. I'm waiting for the book 3 paper to come out still. Okay. I thought it was already everywhere. I'm already at my second book, almost. All the thick paper out the first book is already used. So I had to make my second book. So, now these were the pictures for the left side. Now I'm going to look how and because I used the red retro labels on the right side, I use them on the left side also. '50 was planned here, but almost a little bit higher. Maybe this one also a little bit higher. And then I have a special delivery. And this one is also out of Irish Shutter. Only this is a cross stitch edge. Okay, this one. Maybe here one. And here a little. Yes. Okay. Want a life not to get in the way. Do you not forget to like and comment? So you make a chance for that gift card, $50 gift card. A little bit straight, yes. Yes. My job takes time away from my crafting. Hello, Kathleen. Kijk, het is van uit de middel. Zo, yes. En dat black one. Ja, I don't make plans anymore. The last weeks, if I make a plan, then it's everything is going. Otherwise, then I planned. Have I still a half one? No. What I have here. This can I use? Maybe. So. I love the maroon shade of the red. I have used it on my Christmas tree for years. I exit with gold. Okay. Yeah, it's an old stamp I used on that thread, on that retro label. It's from a German company, I think. So. And these parts I cut off, I always don't throw them away. I do them in the same case as I do the rest. So now I do the edges again. New dies and stamps are supposed to be delivered today. Okay. Do you all have also so many problems with the posts? Here the post is terrible. Always at Christmas time. And now in the lockdown, I think it's still more different for the shops to get it on time. So. I wanted the closed box. Under and the open box with the yummy stuff higher, but I want also the special delivery. It must not come on a reinforcer opening. So. Okay, now start with this one. Got to go nearly 12 hours with a toddler and a 4-year-old test time. Ah, go rest, Honora. We love our grandchildren, but they make us tired. I know. We are not so very young again, and they cost a lot of energy sometimes, especially the young ones. Is it straight or not? Yes, okay. Yes, this all paper. The red reminiscence book tree. So. Yes. I was almost gluing at the wrong side because I want to read the comments. Special delivery. It was a special delivery because it was a surprise for me. A thank you surprise. Then I have the 50, and I had cut out the 50 in the same paper as this one. But I don't like it as much in one color, so I thought maybe two with shade is better. And I go look at my computer to see if that's okay. Maybe Santa brings me new toys to play with. I hope for you, Amy. Which one do you like? So? Black and the red ones, or only the black ones? Or only the Redmond's Bitter Flower. Tell me, please. Like the number shade. Like it with a drop of shadow. Shading. I think the most is the shading. Only the black. Black with the flower. Black ones. Oh, now it's most of the black ones. Or the black ones behind. Red and black. You are not helping me this way. Now, I think I go look once again. Yeah. I wait a little bit so I can see it on my computer screen. Then I see it better. No. Then I put this one on. Only black, 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 black. Nah, it's gonna be black. Thank you. So. Then I use the red ones another time. I don't see it as well now. So. Right, so yes, but please cut out the white in the red zero. Yeah, that's the background of the double-sided adhesive. Look, it's I always cut numbers and my reinforcements with the double-sided adhesive. So the white is gone now. So, and then I had some pieces of Tim Holtz. And here a round one. You see, in all the pieces also from Tim Holtz is black or red. So I make it also match with the rest of the paper. Now I take my reinforcements boxes. What was the code for the set that the border strip you used on the right? Okay. I take it. This was 1652 Planner Essentials 8. Now I'm going to take my box of reinforcements and I'm going to look what I'm going to use. And this one is also done, so that one. I think I'd go for different ones. Yes. Round one. round one, and the rest I think also round ones. Shall I do this? Yes. Thank you, Laura. So, and before I forget, Wednesday, Esther and Els are going together live. I think that is going to be a really nice live. It is a question and answer live. So, if you have any questions, you can ask them Wednesday, when they are together. And that's a nice, I think it's a nice live. With lots of love, I think. So, yes, that will be fun, I think also. So I set my watch for that time so that I can look, because I think it's gonna be funny. Most of the time I try to watch, but said already, December is not the most fine month for me. And my husband is very busy, so he just came from the table, he just eat, because he was late at home. The dishes are on the table, or maybe now he's back with our dog, he is doing the dishes, but I understand if he don't, because he is very tired after a long, long day. I must take it a little bit closer. Thank you, Sir Stamplot. You can also watch it back, Margaret. But then you can not ask your own questions. No. Come on. So I throw this aside and then I go make the rounds a little bit opener. So I see it is still early. Do you want me to show how I made this one? Let me know, because I then can do that quick for you. Because my pages are ready. And I can show you how I did this one. How I made this one. if you want. I always cement after and then I go back to a week. Yes, please. Okay, now. I think I have all the things here. Yes, that is the stamp. Yes, and paper. I only must look for the big stamp. Well, that's no problem, I think. Yes, yes. So, yes, please. Now, so these are my pages for week 50. They can go in the planner. That is always looks always better if they're in the planner page. Planner. So this looks fine. Only here I must write something, but that is for later. Now I'm going to do that side. This one I used a Penny Black script. I can look if I can have it also here. I have a lot of drafts with stamps. So if you have one stamp with a script, this is a wooden with rubber, but you can also use acrylic, of course. And this is a marble stamp, a big one. So that's all aside. Then I have used most of all the paint on natural. I take a piece off. Then I only must have an acrylic block. And I think I go for the same red, the H Mahogany. That is what I have here. And you can use any retro label you want. My red is not so good anymore. I must re-ink them, but I think it's going to work for this time. So, yes. And there's no problem that you not stamp straight now, because you cut it out later with your scissor. Where did you get the marble stamp? The marble stamp is an old stamp from a German company, and that company is Judekins. Oh, Judekins is USA, I see. Judekins is USA. I don't know if they exist anymore, because they were here every year at the stamp event in Holland. In Holland we have every year a big stamp event, 2 days only. Stamping shops are here then, and they were several years here. The last few years not anymore, because the trip was too big for them. No, I think 6 is enough to show, and then I have 6 new ones myself. Then I don't think this is available anymore. I don't know, Debbie. I don't know if Judekins is. And I know that a German company sells them also, and that is Heim Design. But I think a lot of companies have marbled. And you could. look at your stuff. I think you can find it something you can use, because I have several different crackles and how do you say that? Texture, but I don't know how to name that. Letter backgrounds. I saw some Dutch of people have used a lot of other stuff to do this, because I made a video about this, and some people did make some fine stuff with it. I'm going to stand because there's a very big I remember we made our own marbling paper in the college art class. Okay. Yes, but I think there are other companies that have marbled stamps. So. And you see, my ink is not so wet anymore, but I think you can see what I was. No, you see it not so good. I try to take it closer for you, but I must re-ink this. And then simple, you cut it out with your scissor. I have left a small edge, just like I did with the other things today. But look at your background stamps. Look at your background stamps, what you have, and try this out. I think you get more beautiful things than you think. So this one is a little bit better stamped, this one also, but as I said, I must re-ink. I put them on my desk and then I go re-ink him tomorrow. So I make this ones, and this one I have green ones already made also. Look. And this one you can use in your planner or your Sidekick page or UTN. It doesn't overwhelm if you want to add other things. No, if I want to take the text sentiment, I go look if I have that here. Yes, I have one. Then you can use it. I take a round one. And I go in for my black ink, black for you. Yes, Cora, you can use all background stamps you have. That's correct. See? And as you use a lighter ink, because here I have the edge black and the inside I have gray, light gray. Here I use the same because it's not so heavy. But if you do then a lighter stamp, that looks also great. Now, I hope that I have learned you something today. Super tips and much appreciated. Okay, you're welcome, Laura. Are there any questions? Thank you. No questions? No. Now, I hope to see you at the live from Esther and Els Wednesday. Because I think it's going to be a nice life, a funny life. And I try to be there also to look. And then I wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. I hope you're staying healthy. And I hope to see you next year again. Yes? Bye-bye.